The information provided is not intended to diagnose or treat any illness and is not to be considered medical advice. This video is sponsored by ME International. This video is not to be copied or downloaded without explicit permission. Permission is given to share this original video via linking or embedding, so long as credit is given to ME International. For more information, please visit www.me-international.org. Myalgic encephalomyelitis, commonly known as ME, is characterized by immune and neurological dysfunction with severe exacerbation of systemic illness following any exertion. It is understood to be an inability to properly generate energy within cells, which often prevents sufferers from working, studying, or otherwise living a normal and functional life. There is currently no official cause or cure for this disease. After an outbreak at the Royal Free Hospital in London in 1955, Dr. Melvin Ramsay described ME and laid the groundwork for recognizing ME as a distinct disease. Over the years, the ME patient population was lumped in with other patient groups with a focus on fatigue and psychological causes, ignoring many of the original characteristics of ME. ME typically has an acute, sudden onset and currently affects about 1 million American men, women, and children. In 2011, a panel of experts, who had over 500 years of combined experience, collaborated to create the International Consensus Criteria, known as the ICC. The precursor to the ICC was the Canadian Consensus Criteria, commonly known as the CCC. What is it like to have myalgic encephalomyelitis? The 2015 Plus One Journal article titled "The Health-Related Quality of Life for Patients with ME/CFS" showed the quality of life for ME/CFS patients is lower than breast cancer, colon cancer, lung cancer, chronic renal failure, and many other diseases. Those with ME are often disabled, and some are so ill they must remain in bed in darkened rooms to manage the neurological issues, including paralysis, with full-time caregivers. The key feature of ME is a post-exertional exacerbation of symptoms affecting immune function, impairing heart function and circulation, as well as impaired cognition. Sometimes labeled as a crash, this post-exertional neuroimmune exhaustion is not going from well to sick, but going from sick to sicker. Many patients are forced to live outside their energy production system to take care of daily living tasks, which leads to periods of being homebound and or bedbound with multiple debilitating symptoms. Seeing someone with ME out in the world does not mean they have recovered. It usually means they have rested up for days and will likely be forced to rest for many more days following this activity. There is no getting around the damaged energy production of ME. Patients are often forced to live in a push-crash cycle, and that has long-term damaging consequences. This quote from the Hummingbirds Foundation for ME website by longtime advocate Jody Bassett, now deceased, paints an accurate and devastating picture of living with severe ME. For people with severe ME, even the smallest movement, thought, touch, light, noise, or period upright can make their already very severe symptoms far worse. Thus, few illnesses demand such isolation and loss of quality of life as severe ME. Very often, people with severe ME can barely communicate or even tolerate the presence of another person. This is what makes ME such a cruel disease and such an isolating disease. The illness can cause an unrelenting level of disability, suffering, and isolation that is just unimaginable to anyone not familiar with very severe ME. So if that is myalgic encephalomyelitis, then what is chronic fatigue syndrome? Chronic fatigue syndrome, commonly known as CFS, has inappropriately become synonymous with ME. CFS was defined by the Fukuda criterion in 1994, encompassing many fatigue patients as well as those who were previously recognized as having ME. In 2015, the Institute of Medicine, now known as the National Academy of Medicine, created a revised criterion known as the MEICC-SEID. SEID stands for Systemic Exertion Intolerance Disease. This criterion, as was done with CFS, ignored many of the distinguishing characteristics seen in myalgic encephalomyelitis. Doctors are being taught to diagnose SEID based on the following symptoms: a greatly lowered ability to do activities that were usual before the illness, persisting for more than 6 months, with required symptoms of post-exertional malaise and sleep problems. In addition, the patient must have either problems with thinking, including memory issues, and/or a worsening of symptoms while standing or sitting upright. This last symptom is also known as orthostatic intolerance, or OI. Because ME has not been widely recognized, most patients have received the diagnosis of chronic fatigue syndrome and have obtained disability under that label. ME International recommends that patients who have been given the CFS, ME-CFS, or SEID diagnosis be evaluated for ME. This re-evaluation should not affect a disability judgment, as disability is based on functional capability. For a diagnosis of ME, symptom severity must result in a significant reduction of a patient's pre-illness activity level. A patient's symptom severity can range from mild to very severe. The CFS-Fukuda, Canadian consensus criteria, as well as the newer ME-CFS-SEID, require a wait time of 6 months before a diagnosis is reached. The MEICC criteria dropped this 6-month wait, and the disease can now be diagnosed at the onset of illness. Diagnosis according to the international consensus criteria requires that a patient must have post-exertional neuroimmune exhaustion, PENE, which is the physical inability to produce sufficient energy on demand. The diagnosis also requires various symptoms from the following categories: neurological impairments, immune, gastrointestinal, and genitourinary impairments, and energy production ion transport impairments. If you have been diagnosed with CFS, ME-CFS, CFS-ME, fibromyalgia, POTS, chronic Lyme, or other immune dysfunction diseases, it is important to be evaluated for ME. Finding a qualified expert that can definitively diagnose myalgic encephalomyelitis is difficult. Most doctors do not understand the reality of ME or been educated on diagnosing ME using the International Consensus Primer. The IC Primer provides clinicians a one-stop, user-friendly reference for ME. An easy-to-use questionnaire can be found at www.meadvocacy.org/resources and is labeled ICC Questionnaire for Patients Over 18. This resource can help patients and doctors make a preliminary diagnosis. Then, doctors can follow the International Consensus Primer, IC Primer, to definitively diagnose myalgic encephalomyelitis and pursue symptom treatments to help improve the patient's quality of life. A link to the MEIC Primer can also be found on the resources page at meadvocacy.org. Many diseases and conditions can be mistaken for ME by doctors who have minimal experience with the disease. If treatment of these conditions resolves the symptoms, patients have been misdiagnosed and do not in fact have ME. So what needs to be done about ME? Patients with ME need to be screened for infectious agents, including viruses and bacteria often associated with ME that are reactivated or opportunistic infections that develop due to an impaired immune system. Doctors, supervisors, judges, and others who are in a position to affect the patients must understand the serious damage that a push-crash cycle can cause. As a society, we need services in place that help patients prevent the push-crash cycle, if these patients are to have an improved quality of life. For many years, graded exercise therapy, known as GET, and cognitive behavior therapy, known as CBT, was the recommendation by doctors, with the expectation that these patients would gradually recover. We now understand that this is not the reality for those who have ME. Forcing patients to do GET has led to a serious exacerbation of the illness, and the damage caused by pushing exercise is known to have led to death. Patients need society to understand the danger of pushing to gradually increase activity. Medical professionals should encourage patients to rest as much as necessary to avoid post-exertional neuroimmune exhaustion, PENE. Severe ME patients are even more isolated due to the severity of their symptoms and are often unable to leave their homes even to seek medical care. They often require full-time caregivers. Unfortunately, due to the lack of recognition about the reality of ME, full-time caregivers are not provided under the current healthcare systems in most countries. The question you may now be asking yourself is, what can be done right now to help patients with myalgic encephalomyelitis? ME International believes that worldwide adoption of the MEICC to diagnose and treat is the fastest way to improve the quality of life of people with ME. This would be effective in getting doctors, governments, and other organizations to properly support ME patients. ME International supports worldwide adoption of the International Consensus Criteria, with education based on the International Consensus Primer, which provides quality guidance for medical professionals. Many patients have found improvement in quality of life from various treatments, including supplements, antivirals, IV fluids, low-dose naltrexone, commonly known as LDN, and most importantly, pacing activities to avoid going outside their energy production capabilities, which would exacerbate all symptoms. Specific treatment information can be found in the ME International Consensus Primer. This video is sponsored by ME International. This video is not to be copied or downloaded without explicit permission. Permission is given to share this original video via linking or embedding, so long as credit is given to ME International. For more information, please visit www.me-international.org. The information provided is not intended to diagnose or treat any illness and is not to be considered medical advice.